Hello dear students, so today we are going to discuss about the experiment number 4 and 5, right? So what is the fourth experiment? Fourth experiment is about addition of two 16-bit numbers, okay? That is an addition of an array of 16-bit numbers, alright? So here there are there is an array of six numbers. You all must be knowing that array is it is a collection of elements. Here the array is of here the elements of an array are numbers. So what is the size of an array? The size of an array is six. Okay, so what are the six numbers of this array? Those are 0 1 1 1 1. 0x indicates that it is an hex number. 0x2222, 0x3333, 0xAAAA and 0xBBBBB and 0xCCCC. So these are the 16-bit numbers of and we have to find the sum of all these numbers. Okay, so first here it is already given that it is a sum. The sum is 2997. So we can use our calculator and we can verify this and come to a conclusion that this is the number we have to get after addition. 3333 plus AAAA some issue here. Okay, so we'll restart again. 1111 plus 2222 plus 3333. We have to change it to the hex. Okay, 1111 plus 2222 plus 3333 plus AAAA plus BBBB plus CCCC. So what is the answer you get? You get as 2997. So this is the answer you have to get. And after you are running your after executing your program, okay, so we you have to write a program so that you can add all these elements of the array. So you begin writing the program, that is area indicates it is a assembler directive. Okay, it tells the assembler that this area belongs to the code. Okay, so this is the code area and the name of the code is addition. Okay, you can this is a user defined. It means that you can write any name, okay, which gives a proper meaning to this program. Okay, fine. Entry, it is another it is called as an assembler directive. It directs the assembler that kill Microsoft. It is an assembler. Okay, so kill Microvision 4 is an assembler. So it directs this assembler directive entry. It is called, this keyword entry is an assembler directive. It indicates that from here the assembler should start executing. Okay, it is the first instruction which is to be executed. Okay, start move R5 comma R6. Okay, so what it is doing is your this instruction is moving a number 6 into R5. Okay, register 5. Okay, why? Because we have six numbers of elements, okay, or six numbers in an array. Okay, next is move R0 comma hash 0. That means R0, it is assigned to sum, so R0 is 0, assigned to 0 initially. Load register R1 with the value of 1. See, you have to define an array. So this array is defined from a particular address. That address is this value 1. See, actually this value 1 is a label to this address location. Okay, you cannot remember the numbers easily, right? So to remember the numbers easily, we translate them into labels. Okay, so this value 1 indicates our address wherein all these values are stored. Okay, all these values in the sense the six elements of the array are stored. Okay, so DCW value 1 means that address. DCW means defined constant word. Okay, it is all these 16 bit numbers. Value 1, what it does it? It is a memory location, and defined constant word means it will set aside some values. It set aside some what addresses to store these numbers. Okay, next is load R none is equal to value 1. That is the lower address of the first value. That means this value it will be taking 32 bit number. It is right, so it will take that value, that number into R1. As you all know, that the register are 32 bit. Okay, LDR. Next is loop. Okay, loop is another label for this address. Okay, so LDR, that means load register R2 comma R1 comma hash 2. What does this do is it will align the word to an array element. Okay, this will be clear when I explain you the flow of this program. For time being, you just remember that it will capture this array element. Okay, next is LDR R3 comma mask. So R3 is another register. It will hold what is there in the this address, that is labeled mask. Okay, so mask is another address which is having a value of 0x0000FFFF. So this is the 32 bit number which is used as a mask. Defined constant double word it is. Okay, so this is another 32 bit number, so which is nothing but a mask number. So that is loaded into R3. Okay, and R2 comma R2 comma R3, that means what? R2 and R3, they both are ANDed, and the result is gone into R2. Okay, next you have to add R0 and R2, and the result is stored in R0. Subtract R5. R5 is nothing but 6 initially, so subtract it by 1. R5 minus 1 this will do, and R5 minus 1, that means 6 minus 1, that is 5, is stored in R5. Okay, now compare this 5 with 0. When you compare this 5 with 0, it will not be equal, right? So branch, if it is not equal, so what is the branch to which it has to go? It is loop. That means it will branch here. Okay, how long it will branch? Till R5 becomes 1. Okay, when R5 becomes 1, then when you subtract 1 from 1, you will get 0. So compare 0 and 0, if it is equal, then you jump to the next instruction. That means it will come out of the loop. Okay, so in detail we'll just go through this program. So this is the first initial values of the registers. That means R5, that is used as a counter, sum it is a 0, R0 is used as a sum, and array value, that is R1, is equal to 1111222. That is the first number. Okay, that is this one, R1. Okay, this will. Okay, now this value it will be taking. Now next step is R2 comma R1 comma hash 2. That step has to be done, right? So here R2 comma R1 comma hash 2. So it will align it in this fashion. Okay, this instruction LDR R2 comma R1 comma hash 2. It will align in this fashion. All right. So this is done. Next is R3 comma mask. So mask value is nothing but 0000FFFF. Now and R2 comma R2 comma R3. That means R2 and R3 are ANDed, and then the result is put into R2. Okay. So ANDing means what? See, FFFF means what? FFFF means F1F is equal to how do you write F as 1111, and this is ANDed with, I'll just show you this one, this calculation. okay, the rest is the same. So what is 1 you write it as 0 0 0 1. So 1 when you add it with f, you'll get what is the number, that only you'll get. Okay, so this will be 1, this will be 1 and 0 0 1 and 0 0 1 and 0 0. So what is the answer? It is 1, right? So this is the answer for this calculation. So similarly, 1 and f is 1, 1 and f is 1, 1 and f is 1. So you'll get this R2 as 0 0 0 0 1 1 1 1. Okay, so whenever you add any number with f, you'll get the same number. Okay, so this is what you have to remember. Okay, this is called as a masking. Here you are, what you're doing is you are masking these numbers. Okay, that means you are eliminating these numbers. In order to eliminate any number, you have to use the mask. Okay, so you eliminate these numbers and you'll get 1 1 1 1 as the answer. That has to be moved into R2, and then R2 is added with R0. Okay, so R0 is 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0. Okay, when you add anything to 0, it will be the same number. That is 1 1 1 1. So this is the result you get after the first iteration, that is the first loop. Okay, so subtract R5 by 1, you'll get 5. Okay, compare it with 0, you'll get that it is not equal to 0. Then you have to branch to the next loop. Okay, in the second loop again, you can see that R5 has reduced to 5, some R0 updated value is 0 0 0 0 1 1 1 1. All right, and the next array value, see what it will do is this instruction LDR R2 comma hash R1 comma R1 hash 2, it will swap it. Okay, that means initially it was this one R2 in this loop, and again it has aligned in this fashion. Okay, 1 1 1 1 2 2 2 2. Again the same thing, you have to mask it with R3, eliminate these things. Okay, you'll get 2 2 2 2, add it with R0, that is 1 1 1 1. Okay, you add it with 1 1 1 1, and then the result is 3 3 3 3. Updated value of this R0 is 3 3 3 3. All right, next you have to recrement your R5. R5 will be 5 minus 4, that is equal to 4, and you compare with R5 with 0, you'll get that it is not equal to 0. Then you have to again branch it to the next loop. Okay, in the next loop, that is the third loop or the third iteration. Okay, what are the updated values? First you have to note down, that is for R5 equal to 4, sum is equal to 0 0 0 0 3 3 3 3. Array value, that is the next set of the numbers, that is this one 3 3 3 3 a a a a. Okay, so this it will take, that is value 1. Okay, how it will take? Because after every instruction the program counter will be, you know, it will be incrementing, so therefore it will the value will be going on changing. Okay, so R1 is this value. When you when this instruction happens, then it will realign it to this fashion. Okay, initially what it will take, it will take it as 3 3 3 3 a a a a. Okay, and it will align it as a a a a 3 3 3 3. Okay, again you have to mask, by masking you eliminate this a a a a, you'll get it as 3 3 3 3. Add it with R0. Okay, R0 is 3 3 3 3, and by adding you'll get 6 6 6 6. Okay, so the updated value of R0 is 6 6 6 6. Okay, and you subtract R5 from 1, 1 from R5, you'll get R5 as 3. Okay, compare R5 with 0, if it is not 0, again you iterate. Okay, so this is the fourth iteration. In this fourth iteration, R5 is equal to 3, sum, that is R0 equal to 6 6 6 6. Okay, array value, again this, what it will do, it will realign, it was a a a a 3 3 3 3. Okay, so it will realign it as 3 3 3 3 a a a a. Now what you'll do, you'll mask these numbers. Okay, 4 bits of the MSB, you'll mask it, LSB 4 bits you'll take, you'll add it with R2, okay? R2 comma R3, you'll just AND it to mask it, and then add R0 comma R0 comma R2. So R2 is ANDed with R0, okay? And you'll get this as the result, okay? Again, you subtract R5, that is decrementing the counter. You'll get R5 as 2, and you compare it with R5 with 0. You'll get the answer that R5 will not be equal to 0, and then you again loop it. Okay, that is the fifth loop. Okay, or the fifth iteration. Okay, the fifth iteration, again the same steps will go on. The next set of the value will be taken. That is CCCCBBBB. Okay, like that it will be taken. Okay, so CCCCBBBB, it will be taken. It will be realigned in this fashion, CCCCBBBB. Okay, after realigning, you see here, it will be taken as BBBBCCCC. Okay, realign it, we will get it as CCCCBBBB. Okay, now you mask it. Okay, you eliminate all the CCCC and you will get only BBBB. Okay, after elimination, you add it with R0, the new and updated value of R0. You'll add it and you'll get 0001 CCCC CCCB. Subtract R5 by 1, you'll get it as 1, the answer as 1. Compare R5, that is R5 value is 2, it was 1. Compare it with 0, if it is not equal, then again you have to loop. So in the last, that is sixth iteration, R5 is equal to 1, sum R0 equal to 0001 CCCB, R1 equal to BBBB CCCC, R2, okay, you have R2 is realigned, okay, so that is BBBB CCCC, okay. Next, you have to mask it, that is eliminate BBBB. To eliminate BBBB, you multiply with 000FFFF, okay, so and it. That means multiply, add R0 comma R0 comma R2, okay? So this R0 will be what? R0 is this number. You add this number with R2, and the result you will get, have to store in R0. So this is nothing but the last answer, that is 0002997. Now R5 value is 1. You have to subtract R5 by 1. Now R5 value is 1 minus 1, that is 0, so R5, it will become 0. You compare R5, that is 0, with 0, you'll see that R5 will, it is equal, okay? So therefore, when it is equal, you have to, what you have to do, when R5 equal to 0, then you have to jump to the next instruction, that is load register R4 equal to result, okay? So you have to load in the register R4 the label or the address of the label result, okay? So address, that is result, that is this one, okay? This is the address which has define constant double word 0000000, okay? 0x0 means all are zeros. So this address, wherein all the bytes are zero initially, its address, that is address, is labeled as result. This label is, or this address is stored in R4. That means what? From R4, you have to store the result in, you have to store the result of R0 value, which will be there, no? That you have to store in R4. Okay? So this, the result is got in the register R4 or this label, okay, that is result, okay. So this is the end of the program. Now we'll just execute it, okay. Heal Microvision 4, double click on this, okay. Go to project, new Microvision project, exp4, okay, enter, and you have to select the component. So you have to select NXP from Philips. Yeah, this one. Okay, now in this LPC2148, okay, then you just reject this, say no, and then go to file, new. Okay, here you have to write the project. To save time, I'll just copy paste this. Save this. Okay, exp4.asm. Done. And next is to add the this .asm file to this target. So add, look for the ASM file. You have to type it exp4.asm. Add it. Close it. After adding, you have to see that the file enters in this folder. Okay. So next is translate. After doing that, first thing you'll get that if there are errors are there. Here there are errors. There are two errors. Look at the error number one where it is. It is there in the first line. So this area, you have to do some alignment operation here. I've done that. Save it, enter. Okay, there are no errors. Errors have been removed. Okay, so all these three steps you have to do to compile it. Next is go to debug and start or stop debug session. Hit okay, and your code is now debugged. Okay, next is you have to start the simulation. Okay, so if you want to see the execution step wise, then here is an option to run it in the step wise. Okay, that is step wise you can go on seeing what are the changes which is happening. So that is R5 is 6 and R1 has the value of the array address of the R5 0x0040. Okay, here you see that from 40 all the arrays and elements are there. 1 1 1 1 2 2 2 2 3 3 3 3 a a a b b b and c c c c. okay, next when I hit the next step, okay, you'll see that R2 has, you know, realigned it. Okay, next masking R3 is stored with 0000FFFF. Okay, and it has masked, and R2 is stored with the new value of the that is after masking, that is 0011111. It has got rid of 2222. Okay, next it has added with R0. R0 was initially 0000, right? It has added with that 1111. So R0 will be 0000111. Okay, and R5 is 6. Next it will become 5. That is, it is decrementing. It will enter into the next loop. Okay, wherein it will fetch, R2 will realign itself to the new value, that is 1111222. It will eliminate 1111. Okay, and after eliminating, okay, you pay attention to the registers which are in a blue color highlighted. Okay, it will add it with the R0. R0 is updated. Next is you have to decrement the register, that is R5, that is counter, that is 4. From 5 it has gone to 4. Okay, so I hope you have understood the stepwise operation. Now I'll execute all it all at once, that is this option F5, and you can stop. I made a mistake here because I did not insert a breakpoint. Okay, so it has executed this point. So we'll just go to the main program, or we'll this is the main program. Here we'll insert a breakpoint at the first no operation. Okay, here what it will do is, here just right click and insert a breakpoint. Okay, now we'll just reset the CPU and run it again. Okay, now you get the answer as 2999. 7. So this is what you have to do to execute this program. Okay.